Hey guys, John V here from Phone Ring. Right now, I just got in the Asus Transformer Pad 300. Just gonna do a quick unboxing just to give a little bit of info. We checked this guy out first at MWC. It's pretty much the inexpensive version of the Transformer Prime, similar in specs and overall size, but it's priced lower. And instead of being metallic, it's constructed out of plastic. So let's get started with this unboxing here. You have an image of the tablet itself, and of course, you could purchase the optional keyboard dock to make it, you know, to like a netbook of some sort. You got a profile view of the tablet. I don't think it's an accurate portrayal, but its thinness. It's a little bit thicker than that. And on this, there's three different colors. There's a red, kind of bluish, and a white, and a silver whitish color available. The one we have is like the bluish one. And some more brandings across the side. HDMI powered by NVIDIA Tegra. And in the back, there's nothing except for the serial information. So let's get started with this guy here. So open up, and here we are. With the Asus Transformer Pad 300. Quickly look at these tidbits here at the bottom right. It's already powered on. It's the NVIDIA Tegra 3 quad-core processor, 9.9 millimeters thick. It's also 635 grams in weight, 178 degrees wide viewing angles with its IPS display, similar to the Asus Transformer, the original one. 8 megapixel camera in the rear. It has these crystal pure sound reproduction, and mentioned already, the optional keyboard dock, and has Android 4.0 ice cream sandwich out of the box, and we can clearly see that here in the home screen. So let's take this guy out, and then we'll take a look and see. Take a look at this guy here in a moment. Let's take just a quick peek at, see what else is included with the packaging here. So, you have your usual set of documentation, most likely, here. There we go. Documentation, warranty card, user's manual. There you go, that's typical. You have your proprietary USB cable, just like the Transformer Prime, and the Transformer 4 wall charger, like so. And not something you typically find, but it's nice, we're grateful to see it. You have a cleaning pad, looks like a microfiber cloth. To clean the tablet, so I'll keep it nice, squeaky clean. So let's put that all aside. Let's take a look at the Transformer Pad 300 here. Now, we already did a hands-on, so we're just going to tell you some of the stuff that really comes out at us right here, first time we're looking at it. So instead of metallic back cover, it has a plastic. You can notice the blue texture, just like the original Transformer. Somewhat, you know, lightweight, still reasonably slim. And it's solidly built despite being a plastic device. Around the sides, we have just the micro HDMI out port. You have the volume controls here. You got one speaker right there, it looks like. You have a front-facing camera as well. The bottom, the dock connection port, the two notches there for that as well. And on the right side, just a 3.5 millimeter headset jack. You have also, looks like the speaker opening right there. And 8 megapixel camera, no flash, unfortunately. So that's that. The other thing that really stands out with this guy here is just the IPS display. 1280 by 800 pixels, so WXGA 10.1 inch. Nothing really different about it. It's not the IPS Plus display that's used on the Transformer Prime, but still, good contrast, bright, and it's colorful, natural colors, and good viewing angles too, so it maintains its clarity no matter how we look at it. And finally, the other big thing about this guy is just the NVIDIA Tegra 3 quad-core processor. It just makes this guy run pretty fast with pretty much all the operations right out of the box. You could tell it barely slows down. I'll probably load up the albums here. So it loads them all up. Looks nice. And let's just test it out and see what happens if we put a live wallpaper or something a little bit more graphically intensive here. So let's do something like this here. See this guy. And look at that. Pretty responsive, quick, instantaneous, maintains fluidity. And of course, even in portrait, normally we tend to see some slowdown with Android tablets, but it's not stopping whatsoever. Let's try a different one here, just to show you guys the kind of processing power this guy has to offer. Let's do the black hole one here, see what that looks like. And there you go. Still maintains that smooth feel with its movement, so pretty nice. We're excited about it. It's priced modestly at $399, $400 for the 32 gigabyte base version, which is this guy here. So you save yourself some money. We're going to check it out a little bit more and find out how it handles. So if you want to learn more about the ASUS Transformer Pad 300, check out our website, guys, phonearena.com. This is John V. Thanks for watching.